The ladies, the gentlemen, I would like, or you would like to present some our regulations and some our experience related to activation and evaluation of scientific activity of PhD students in our university and also in our country. So let me remind you, maybe I will switch off camera. Let me remind you the system of academic career in Poland. So in the lowest level, we have a bachelor or engineering. So this is the first period of studies. In the case of bachelor, 3 years. In the case of engineer, 3.5 years. The second level is master of science. Then we have a PhD studies and as a result, doctor. So this the we are focused on this stage of education, academic education. Then we have a habilitated doctor and finally professor. The highest level is professor. So this is a national system for Polish high schools. This is a national system of academic career in Poland. I would like mention about supervisors and reviewers, because during our discussion in Moscow, there's different types of opinion about who can be supervisor of PhD students. In Poland, we have a strictly defined that supervisor of students can be only habilitated doctor or even better professor. This same with reviewers, because in the final step of PhD thesis evaluation, reviewers prepare reports related to PhD thesis, and also reviewers can be only habilitated doctors and professors. So let me remind you some general information about doctoral schools in Poland. This is something new. We started doctoral school system last year. Previously, we had doctoral studies. So this is something new, but in general, it's very similar to previous system. So doctoral schools is a 4 years school. Students receive scholarships depending on the level of the studies. In the beginning, for the first 2 years, they have 450 euros. In the second level, I mean third and fourth year, 700 euros per month. We have, of course, study program. I presented the study program during our meeting in Latvia. So, of course, the presentation is available in Google Drive, so you can find this this presentation. I don't want to concentrate on study program because this program was presented previously. Moreover, students are obligated to do some practical classes, classes in academic didactics. There's a 60 hour per year. Of course, such classes are conducted under supervision of experienced academic teacher. However, the most important part of scientific of PhD studies are scientific research. So this is the most important part of our studies, our PhD program, and I will concentrate on this this part of PhD studies. In our university, we have four doctoral studies, doctoral schools, doctoral school for humanities, for social science, for medicinal and health science, and chemistry belongs to the school of exact and natural sciences. Okay. So in all cases, as I mentioned before, doctoral theses are based on scientific research made by PhD student under supervision of professor or habilitated doctor. This is very, very, very important, and it is also very strictly defined in our regulations. So what we use for activation of our PhD students, in general, we use approach of carrot and stick. And I would like to show you the main points of our activity in this area. So, as I mentioned, our PhD student, we have a four-year PhD studies, you can see here. And after each year, we evaluate, each student is evaluated. So we prepare together with students evaluation report. This report is very, very important. You will see later that this report is used for different issues. So as you can see, after each year we have we evaluate scientific activity of our students. Moreover, we have something like intermediate report. I don't know what it exactly means, because it is something new. The first such evaluation, intermediate evaluation report will be prepared after the next academic year. So let's see what we evaluate every year for each student in our university. Oh, maybe one more thing. I mentioned about this, that for first 2 years before intermediate report, the student scholarship is 450 euros, and after positive evaluation of intermediate report, this scholarship increased to 700 euro per month. Okay, so what we evaluate every year after completing each academic year. So this is a table which presents points which are evaluated. The first and the most important point is related to publication of scientific papers in journals indexed by Journal of Scientific Citation Report, Journal of Citation Report. As can you see, for evaluation we use impact factor of journal in which the article was published, and we multiply this impact factor by 15. So this is a very and the most important point in our evaluation report. The highest amount of points can be collected by publishing of scientific paper in high-ranked journal. Moreover, we have we also evaluate other journals.
Please mute your microphone if you're attending the meeting. Only speakers are allowed.
Okay, so I will continue. So moreover, we evaluate also other journals, so not indexed, but this database, but for each article you can obtain only 4 points. Then we have abstracts in abstract of international conferences and national conferences. In case of international conferences, we have 0.4, in national 0.2. However, you can collect, or student can collect only 10 such activities. So the maximal number of points for these activities is 4 points. So in the case of international conferences, 10 conferences gives 4 points. If students had more such activities, there is not added to this number. Moreover, we also have points for co-author of scientific book in English, 40 points. Co-author of scientific book in Polish or other languages, 30 points. Scientific book translation, 12 points. Moreover, participation in projects. I mean national and international project, because we have also our university project, but this university project are not included in this point. So for participation in scientific project on national or international level, student may obtain 6 points, but only once in the year when the project is starting. In the case of projects, but in the case where PhD student is head or manager of this project, the students may obtain 20 points, patent application, 8 points, in the case of national patent, in the case of international patent, 16 points. Moreover, we have participation in international conference organization as a head of organization committees, 15 points. international conference, but member of organization committee, 10 points, national conferences as a head of organizing committee, 10 points, national conference, member of organizing committee, 5 points, chairman of the conference session, 1 point, invited lecturer in English, 8 points, invited lecturer in Polish, 4 points. So we collect all these points and we obtain the final result. And this final result is very important because I will, as you will see later, we use the results of this evaluation report for different competition for projects, for our university scholarships. I will show you later in the next slide. It's important because apart from such table with points from different activities, we have also we also need description of evaluation research activity by supervisor of the PhD student. So supervisors should evaluate what was done, what should be done, what is planned for the next year, and also what is very important, supervisor should evaluate the time needed for completing a PhD dissertation. So it is important to see in which point student is. If he is maybe a little bit late, or maybe he or she is in time, so this is also important. And such a report is evaluated, and of course there are two possible results of such evaluation. The first one is positive, so in this case student will be awarded the PhD scholarship for the next academic year. In the case of negative evaluation, there is the problem because student can be suspended of the PhD scholarship for the next academic year. Moreover, there is some other very important issues related to this annual evaluation report. Because in our university, we have two types of students for best PhD students. The first one is pro-quality PhD scholarship. This our there are scholarships on the Jagiellonian University level. So the first one is pro-quality PhD scholarship. About 30% of PhD students can receive such scholarship. There is about €250 per month. And of course, this 30% of students is taken from the rank list based on annual evaluation report. So it is very important to be a very good student, to have a very good results, to have a lot of papers, to obtain very good result, to be very high on rank list, and in this case you can, such student can obtain additional scholarship. Another scholarship is Jagiellonian University Rector's PhD scholarship. In this case, the only 10% of PhD student, the best PhD student, can receive such financial support. In this case, we have also €250 per month. So you can see that if you are in a group of 10% of the best PhD students in our university, you can obtain extra €500. What does it mean in Kraków? It means that student may rent very elegant flat in the center of Kraków. So it's for Poland, for Kraków, it's a lot of money. It's a lot of money, and it may change the quality of life in Kraków. However, we have also some more carrots. We have also national scholarships for PhD students. Such scholarships are distributed by Ministry of Science and Higher Education. Of course, there is a competition about such competition for such scholarships. And in this case, also the scientific achievements are the based point for evaluation, for competition. And last year, I mean in 2019, in Poland, 840 students obtained such special scholarships from our ministry. And the amount of money was 4,000 euro per year. So it's again a lot of money. Moreover, apart from scholarships, we have also special grants for students, for PhD students, grants on the university level, and also grants on the national level. And I would like to start from grant. Grant university grant for grants for PhD student, and we have special grants. Of course, again in this case for evaluation for the competition, we use two things. The first one is results from student evaluation report. The second parameter is, or the second thing which is evaluated is quality of application that was prepared by student, by PhD student. So we evaluate the quality of proposed research, the novelty of research, the scientific, the experimental method that can be used, and so on. And we take both results from evaluation of application and results from annual report, and we take both these parameters to evaluate and decide who can obtain such a grant. Also in this grant we have the finances I divided for two parts. The first part is scholarship, so the scholarship is about 150 euro per month. And the second part is part for chemical, for small equipment, for conference fee, and so on. And in general, the total cost of such grant is between 3,000 to 5,000 euro, and grant duration is 10 months. And every year we organize such competition, we collect applications from students, and we distribute such grants for our PhD students. About 10% of students are awarded by such grants. Moreover, we have also some grants for PhD students is offered by National Science Center in Poland. And we have three types of grants, such national grants for PhD student. The first one is Preludium. This is for our old system of doctoral studies. Students can apply for such project for 3 years. The allocation of funds is in last year was 3,800,000 euro. So it's a rather large amount of money. And of course, students prepare application, there's evaluation of application. Of course, the National Science Center takes into account the scientific achievement on student and decide taking into account both these parameters. The second type of national grant is called Preludium Vis. This grant is dedicated for PhD students from doctoral schools. So students can apply for project for 3 or 4 years. The allocation of funds is much larger because there's new project and we expect that the number of PhD students studying in doctoral school will be larger comparing to the old system of PhD studies, that and this is the reason why the amount is very, very large. And this is amount from the last year, and the maximum funds for one project was 42,000 euros. So again, this is a very important support for scientific research. Of course, in case of all projects, students should prepare or must prepare special report. Of course, we expect that there will be some papers based on research done in the frame of such project. And the last project is Etuda, and this project is only for PhD scholarship. Such scholarship is about 700 euro per month for 20 months. And last year, 100 grants was distributed among the best about the best PhD student. Okay. And the final evaluation of students, of course, is done by reviewers of PhD thesis. As I mentioned, such reviewers can be only professor and habilitated doctors. And such reviewers prepare review reports. And in this review report, they evaluate the concept of the studies, quality of research, data processing, and so on. However, what is very, very important, in each such report should be presented the elements of scientific novelty of the research. So each PhD study, each PhD thesis should contain elements of research scientific novelty. It is a very important point because each reviewer must prepare a special paragraph in which there is a statement that the PhD thesis contains elements of research novelty. Moreover, each reviewer can list what research novelty is included is in this specific PhD thesis. So this is very important point. And finally, I would like to show you scientific achievement of my last PhD student, Sylvia Basson, then changed for Górecka after she was married. She was studying under my supervision in period 2015-2019, and you can see a list of papers in which she is co-author. This is the next part. You can see there is some more formal papers not related to doctoral thesis. We prepared together a chapter to scientific book. She attended 12 conference and in this group for international conference as a presenter. And she obtained a PhD diploma with distinction. So this is one of the, well, maybe better than average PhD thesis in our department. And finally, after PhD defenses, there is a special event in which we graduate student with diploma. You can see it's my PhD student, it's me, our rector. So it was in our old university building. Maybe a few of you had a possibility to do some sighting of this our university building. So this is all what I would like to tell you. So thank you for your attention.
Thank you. We have one question for presentation from Asel Imashova. How many minimum points are for positive results? Could you please answer, Lucia?
It depends because there is no strict barrier, pass to or not. In general, we take results, we take such evaluation reports from all students. We see what is the average and try to find the cutting, the point which is cut. But in general, we expect at least one paper a year. This is the most important, very important. If okay. There is no any scientific paper published during academic year, there is not problem. If students have not published during 2 years any paper, during academic years, there's a serious problem for students.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.